Smaller is better. Well, that was the trend with my old Idabao videos, but you know, sometimes bigger is better, right? Right. Anyways, the Idabao ID87 has gotten quite a facelift, and it's been a good 6 months or so since I've taken a look at a TKL. Oh, that was still back when I did silent films. Well, formal apology to the TKL gang, maybe I'll do more in the future. In this video, I'll be taking a look at the Idabao ID87 V2. I'm gonna be building it out with some tangerines, which are stock, and these Akko blue keycap things. Now this is definitely a peculiar combo, using stock tangies and weird OEM keycaps. What's going on here? To be perfectly honest with you, it's what I had my ID87 built out with, so that's what we're running with, comparison time. I'll be putting this board head to head with its younger brother, so stick around, have some fun. If you look really closely at this blue void, I think you can see a key cult. Wait, oh no, it's that 77% of you aren't subscribed. Well, you better fix that. Hit subscribe. Anyways, let's get down to the nitty gritty. Idabao is a sponsor of this channel and sent this prototype board out for review. I get a lot of flack for being an Idabao shill, but I think I trash them just as much as anyone else, so yeah. Obviously everyone has their biases, and that's why I give you these disclosures so you can make smart purchasing decisions. Yeehaw. Anyways, this is the standard grab bag of Idabao accessories, and this board came in a heap of bubble wrap. I was very... I don't know what's going on here. This took a generation to unwrap. So if you're watching this video on release, then the board is currently in group buy and you can purchase it for $219. If you're watching this after release, then there's a good chance that it'll be in stock after they ship out all of the units, as that typically tends to happen with any Idabao board. Now, they say that their expected shipping time is June 25th, but Idabao's been having a lot of issues with fulfilling some of their stuff lately, so I would expect this to be delayed at least a month or two. Anyways, what's the board, Hippio? What's the board? Well, this is a TKL, or 10 keyless, meaning somebody sliced off the number pad, but left everything else intact. It comes in three colors, a black, a white, and a gray, which the gray looks silver, but whatever. And it features a really nice brass weight that's actually built into the bottom plate, so it's removable as well. Speaking of the bottom's made out of acrylic so that you can see the RGB underglow, if you're into that type of thing. They've also upgraded this bad boy to be significantly thicker than normal, and we'll talk about that more later. Just like the ID87 V1, it features white per-key lighting. This means no RGB on the top, but RGB on the bottom. If you're into this type of thing, then hey, that's a perk. Mr. Coffee Scale. Also, let's take a look at the build quality, and the weight. It comes in at 1800 grams, or right around 4 pounds. That's about 500 grams heavier than the V1. So this board is significantly less hollow than most Idabao boards, and we'll talk about why later. But first, I have an award to give to Idabao.
The worst stabilizers in any board I've ever seen.
Award. Congratulations. Alright, well we're gonna have to fix that. And to fix that, let's get the board open using our handy dandy WoW stick. Link in the description. I am a WoW stick shill, by the way. The back plate's connected with 6 screws. And you could just pull that away when you've unscrewed them. As I mentioned before, this backplate is really, really thick acrylic, and it fills in all of the gaps in the case. It leaves essentially no room, and I tried to fit in a little bit of foam in here, but it just did not fit. So, yeah, no dead space. Now, some might see this as a pro or con, but in this case, I actually see it as a con. With the ID87 and standard ID80 designs, you can fill the case with foam or silicone, and it makes the case really muted. But with this, you get one sound profile and you can't really tweak it much. It's weird asking for a board to be more hollow, but honestly, as an enthusiast that likes to tinker with things, I like to have the option to add as much foam as I want. Because this is an integrated plate design, we had to unscrew the PCB from the integrated plate and then pull out the PCB. Now, this is a prototype PCB, so it might not be exactly like the final version. Most notably, it won't be green. Anyways, these stabilizers are absolutely terrible and we're gonna be swapping them out. Because that would be just a crime to use them. However, little did I know that my stabilizers that I decided to pick would be the downfall of this build and cause so much trouble. I decided to use some Morgry stabilizers that I had laying around from Prevail Key Company. And if you want to pick some of these up, then click that link in the description and use code Hippio to save 5% on them. If you like colored stabilizers and want a lot of color variety, then Morgry is a great option. If you want stabilizers that are really easy to tune, then just get some Duroc V2s from the link in the description instead. I lube these up with Krytox 205G0 and XHT-BDZ, or our good friend. If you want to purchase some of this lube and support the channel, then click that link down in the description. Anyways, lubing these was a little bit of a nightmare, and the spacebar ended up not tuned, even though I really tried. I think the wire wasn't balanced, and I couldn't be bothered to balance a wire right now. Anyways, this brings us on to our next big problem. You're probably thinking, oh, Hippio, you just put the PCB in the case, and look, it's so easy. Look at it go. Look, it's gonna fit so well.
No.
Yikes. Yeah, so the integrated plate doesn't fit our stabilizers, and this is a big issue. Now, as you can see, the machining around the stabilizers is pretty rough, and this is probably because it's a prototype. There's a good chance that me bringing up these issues will fix it in the final version, but there's also a chance that it won't, so be aware of what stabilizers you purchase for this board. The Morgry stabilizers have a really weird shape, so I had to sand all of them down for this to fit properly, which was a big yikes. Anyways, onto the build. So we're gonna be building these out with some tangerines. These are stock tangerines, and if you want to see a review of them, hopefully I've put the link up in the top right. If not, I'm gonna hit you with the oopsie. My real life is a little bit crazy right now, so I didn't have the time to lube these and build the ID87 for comparison, so I've kept these stock. Now, this depends on if you like to live dangerously, but I like to support my hot swap sockets from the back while I put it in. This prevents popping sockets out, and is overall just a pretty good idea. Anyways, pop! It slows down the process a lot, but it's worth it because you might not have to solder in a socket if you pop one out. Now, I swear one day I will lube these tangies, but they're 68 gram springs, so I'm gonna have to spring swap them if I ever want to use them anyways. Plus, there's just so many interesting switches out there, like cream pacas or gatter on hippos. But I digress. So I'm not giving the board the best chance here, but these are still really expensive stock switches, so I'm giving it a decent chance. It gets a decent chance. This is just prototype things, but my page down button was broken, and it didn't seem to be a switch or a soldering issue. Anyways, let's get these little rubber feet on, and let's get this build on the road. If they come out, come on, that. This board comes with two different colors of rubber feet, but I'm gonna be using the clear ones here, as I think they just look better than black. I'd say these are pretty essential to put on, as the board slip slides way too much without them. Anyways, so the keycaps here are keycaps that I've poached off of my Akko Silent 87 or something like that. These were originally on the board that I turned into my PewDiePie board, and I decided to use them on my ID87 build when I did the Tangy review, as I thought they looked really nice. I mean, just look at that, that's really nice. But there's a good chance I'll be rebuilding this board with different keycaps and switches on stream or something, so make sure you're subscribed for that. Anyways, let me just cast a magic spell and get these keycaps on. I know you don't want to watch that. Aha. So just like that, the build is done. Wow, building a keyboard's so easy, you could just clap? Who knew? I think this board is super sleek, and overall I like the general aesthetic more than the V1. Also, it has RGB underglow, which is really nice, especially if you want the pro gamer effect and want to get way more kills in Fortnite or whatever. This board should support QMK and VIA on release, but I didn't happen to get the firmware, so you're just gonna have to trust me. QMK and VIA are ways that you can customize your board's layout and customize the lighting and macros, and it's overall a really good selling point. But let's talk a little bit more about that lighting. So this board features per key white LED lighting, which looks a little bit orange here. What's going on? Well, if you have a brain, any white light shining through a colored object is going to take on that color. So I have orange switches here, and guess what? The light turns orange, but I removed the orange switches. Wow, it's a white light. Isn't that crazy? So keep this in mind. Here are the stabilizers. Yeah, you could feel the existential dread in that clip. I got every stabilizer sounding great, besides the spacebar. I gave up on it, I gotta be honest with you. But really, any stabilizer is gonna be better than the ones they came stock with. I've tried lubing those before, and they just cannot sound good no matter what I do. So, compared to the ID87, this boy looks chonkier, but actually sits at about the same profile overall. For some reason, the 87 V1 just looks cheaper, and I mean it's $40 cheaper, so yeah. One big important thing to note though is you can't buy the 87 V1 right now, as it's entirely out of stock. It might come back in stock in the future, but I highly doubt it, and I think the V2 is going to be your only option now. Now, Idobao, I know you're listening. Bring the ID87 Plus, alright? You know what you did with the ID80 Plus? Do that on the ID87. We don't want the ID87 V2, we want the ID87 Plus. Now, this is just rambling Hippio time, but I think the ID80 Plus is way better than the ID80 V2. And in this case, if they did an ID87 Plus, it would be better than the ID87 V2. Sorry, that was long-winded. So my overall impressions of this is it's not too much to write home about. So the main difference here is aesthetics, but there's also a substantial sound difference when you account for the fact that you can't fill it with any foam or anything. If the V1 was still an option, I would recommend the V1 over the V2 probably any day. However, because it's not an option, I have to consider, is this worth it for you if you're shopping for a TKL at this price point? To that, I say maybe, and it really depends on what you care about. The board has an interesting aesthetic, and the RGB underglow is pretty fancy. However, the integrated plate is going to give you a slightly stiffer typing experience than most boards, and you need to decide if you're into that or not. Personally, as someone that's a proud member of Linear Gang, I prefer a stiffer typing experience as I think it just feels better with linears. But you know, that's like my opinion. Anyways, I'll be leaving you guys with a sound test comparing the ID87, V1, and V2. I ask that you please watch the whole thing to support my YouTube algorithm overlords, otherwise they won't let me eat. In fact, if you like this video, do a sound test of your own in the comments and let me know what you thought. If you want to see more content and more Idobao boards, then make sure you get subscribed and ring that notification bell. But not every video I do is an Idobao board. Seriously, guys, please. Please stop bullying. Please. Special thank you to NotSus, Josh, Curbboard, PlattyPlat, Cody J, and Aquarius. Want to know why I thank those lads? Well, it's because they're pretty awesome and they're members of the Hippio's Chosen tier. Want to join them and have your name immortalized in a video? Then click that join button down below. Also, the join button is the best way to support the content that I make. And I'd really appreciate it. Bye.